Antimalarial drugs such as chloroquine and hydroxychloroquine, also known more famously as Plaquenil, are not only being used to treat malaria, but are currently being tested to help treat new viral infections. But they are more famously used to help with symptoms of autoimmune diseases such as rheumatoid arthritis, lupus, and even Sjogren's syndrome. But these medications are considered high risk and potentially toxic to the body, particularly within the retina and the back of the eye, and can even lead to retinal cell death and permanent vision loss. So in this video, we're going to review how Plaquenil affects the eye and what type of special testing you can expect to see if you were ever put on these medications. Let's take a look. Hello and welcome, this is Dr. Alan here from the Dr. Eye Health Show, helping you learn all about the eyes and vision. Now, high-risk medications such as chloroquine and hydroxychloroquine have a long-running history of known systemic complications. However, they also do help a lot of people. Chloroquine originally was developed as an antimalarial drug to fight malaria, a serious but thankfully very rare infection caused by mosquito bites. Later on, hydroxychloroquine, also known by its brand name Plaquenil, was developed as a derivative of chloroquine and is generally used more often due to its better safety profile than its predecessor, chloroquine. And outside of just malaria treatment, these medications are known to help people with chronic autoimmune conditions such as rheumatoid arthritis and lupus. And eye doctors like myself often see patients on these medications for these conditions. The issue is that these medications are known to cause retinal toxicity, and if not caught early enough, can lead to permanent retinal cell death and vision loss. Now, it's not fully understood how Plaquenil affects the retina in the back of the eye. It's believed to somehow inhibit retinal cell metabolism, as well as bind onto melanin cells within the retinal pigment epithelium. That's the far back layer of the retina, right behind the photoreceptor cells. Most eye doctors know Plaquenil toxicity by what's called bullseye retinopathy. That's where the retina in the back of the eye takes the appearance of a dark bullseye right in the macula. Unfortunately, the retina only appears like this bullseye in a very severe end stages of retinal toxicity from these medications. That is exactly why early detection of Plaquenil toxicity is so important. Now that we have reviewed what Plaquenil is used for and how it affects the eye, let's go over the different tests that you'll see in the eye clinic if you're ever put on these medications. But first, let me know in the comments section if you've ever used any of these medications and what your personal opinion is about them. Now keep in mind that recommendations do change with updated research, but at the current timing of this video, these are the screening tools that typically you will expect to see if you go see your eye doctor from being put on these medications. Usually before starting these medications, or right about the time when you're first taking your initial dose, your rheumatologist or your prescribing physician will recommend you see either an optometrist or an ophthalmologist to have these screening tests done. The first thing is that you're going to be asked to have a full eye exam with dilation so that your pupils will be dilated with the eye drops that nobody likes, so that we can see inside the back of the eye and make sure that the retina is in good shape. This may include or may not include retinal photographs as a baseline. Along with just a dilated retinal exam, you can expect to have a 10-2 central visual field test. This is a test where you will look inside of a big instrument with a dot in the middle, and while staring at that dot, they flash these white lights, and you simply click a button if you think you see the flashing lights. These lights are gradually changed in both brightness and location so that your doctor can map out how your side vision is really functioning. Subtle changes to the retinal health can be picked up with this test, and it can be a little challenging, so don't be surprised if your eye doctor does recommend running this test again in the future if you have a tough time with it. After these two standard tests, then your eye doctor will order at least one of the following tests. Could be one, getting a retinal photograph using fundus autofluorescence, which really highlights and measures where in the retina the active metabolism is changing. It could be from an electroretinogram or a multifocal ERG. This is an instrument where it actually measures the electro response of the retina and is extremely sensitive for picking up changes with retinal health. And then they could be using a standard domain optical coherence tomography, which is also known as an SDOCT, which is basically like getting an ultrasound of the retina in the back of the eye. It gives us very high definition images of the retinal cells and can even show us when retinal cells are dying, even before having visual changes. I think that if you are going to be screened or tested for plaquenil toxicity, you're more likely going to see the OCT imaging just because it's more widely available than these other tests. However, if your doctor does have access to a multifocal ERG, they're probably going to order that because it is so sensitive for this sort of disease. Now again, all of these testing are usually done right before starting plaquenil or right about the same time as starting plaquenil. However, these tests are usually only recommended to be done again after using the medication consistently for about 5 years. However, with that being said, from my personal experience talking to other eye care professionals around the country and the world, as well as speaking with rheumatologists who prescribe plaquenil the most frequently, they usually recommend still testing with this sort of plaquenil screening pretty much every single year, just because the risk of retinal toxicity and the permanent damage that can occur is so serious. One of the reasons why plaquenil toxicity to the retina is so serious is that even if your eye doctor catches it and have you taken off of the medication, the damage to the retina can still continue. That's because plaquenil is known to, again, bind those photoreceptor pigment cells in the back of the eye, and it may continually do damage over time. Plaquenil clears from the body very slowly from both the kidneys and the liver, and can be found even years later after stopping its use. Now, thankfully, the overall risk for developing plaquenil toxicity is very low. It's only about 1% after taking that medication for 5 years. However, there are some other associations with higher risk for retinal toxicity. The greater risk factors are being over the age of 60, having a previously diagnosed retinal disease such as macular degeneration, having other known renal or liver disease because, again, the medication is cleared through those routes, as well as being on the medication greater than 5 years, as taking high dosages of the medication, or really your overall cumulative dose. These are all things that your eye doctor will consider when recommending when the next time you should be screened for retinal toxicity due to plaquenil. So if you ever put on a medication such as chloroquine or hydroxychloroquine for things like antimalarial reasons or for an autoimmune condition, make sure to talk with your rheumatologist, your prescribing physician, or your eye doctor about the possible effects on the eye health and the appropriate testing. Otherwise, I hope you got value out of this video. If you did, smash that like button for me and drop a comment in the section below. Otherwise, keep an eye on it, and we'll talk to you soon.